Hi, my name is Vasja. I'm an independent filmmaker from Slovenia. Like many others around the world, I decided to make a change in my life. In 2011, I packed my bags and moved to Berlin. Here are many foreign people from different backgrounds and cultures trying to fit in this society full of rules and order. I was struggling with my work and my relationship. At my worst, I felt I made a big mistake leaving my work and safety behind. But I didn't want to give up. End of 2012, I met a scientist by coincidence. He's pursuing an elusive creature, and his story I'm about to tell you.
Hello there, good people. I'm glad that these people came, and due to who I am and what I am, now I have to reveal something. We know about Dr. Julie Madialamor, who holds multiple characters, so that everybody must be awakened in this climate change. You know that if the Lord have chosen you to become a role model, then He will give you everything that you deserve. And I received something like a special power to reform, to rehab, and to restore. And this is something like for...
We're sorry, the number you have dialed is not in service at this time.
Dr. Bostjan Dvorak has been seeking a caterpillar not yet known to the scientific community for more than 30 years. This obsession has changed his entire life. He doesn't dress, look, or live as others around him. Bostjan is a linguist who speaks 32 languages. He's a keen biologist and a religious person.
Glaube und Wissenschaft müssen sich nicht gegenseitig ausschließen. Sie können einander sehr gut ergänzen, finde ich. Also ich persönlich kann kaum einen Gegensatz finden.
He was born in Piran, a small coastal town in former Yugoslavia, which is today Slovenia, by Slovenian Czech parents. He moved to Germany when he was 14 years old to join his father. His father had fled the former Yugoslavia because he dared to criticize the communist regime. From Germany, he helped Slovenia to get the international recognition of independence by influencing the European intellectual circles. Dr. Bostjan studied comparative linguistics at the Tübingen University and received a doctorate for researching the native North American languages at the Saas Institute in Berlin. Languages are his big passion, but there's another thing he's drawn to. Since early childhood, he's been attracted to insects, especially the caterpillars and moths. Recently, he discovered a species of caterpillar he wants to document. He believes that if given a chance to breed the caterpillar into the pupation stage, it can hatch into an entirely new species of moth. If he can find it, he'll be able to finish a book he started writing more than 30 years ago. But before we get there, let me tell you some bizarre events from his life that led to a series of unfortunate events.
Thank you.
En ce moment-là, je m'occupe de la recherche d'une espèce de papillon qui est bien connue, mais dont la chenille n'était pas encore vue et documentée. Alors, jusqu'à ce moment-là, chacun a vu la chenille et la chenille est complètement inconnue. C'est une question très intéressante. Pourquoi?
Hello, can you hear me? I'm Bostjan Dvorak. I am somewhere in the Mount Makiling. I'm lost in the woods. There was obviously a misunderstanding, so you told me about the way. I just followed the markings, but I am lost now. I'm somewhere very high, and it's very slippery. I'm afraid to fall, so I prefer to stay here, and I will continue tomorrow after daybreak. Please don't worry about me. I'm okay. I'm fine. I could drink some water from the palm leaf. I have found many caterpillars here, and the caterpillar I looked for is also here in your forest. I have a bad connection and my battery is going out. I will just...
The next day at dawn, Dr. Bostjan spotted some men approaching him. The park officials were afraid of bad publicity if something would happen to a foreigner, so they sent a rescue party to find him. And here is where our story begins.
Und dann, vor Tagesanbruch, kam eine Rettungsmannschaft. Man suchte nach mir die ganze Nacht. Ich wusste das nicht. Ich dachte zuerst, es seien Bergbauern, die mich da gefunden hätten. Nein, es war eine Rettungstruppe. Und dann wurde ich ins Tal geführt. Der Bürgermeister und mehrere Journalisten waren da. Und ich habe mich mit der Assistentin des Botanikinstituts angefreundet. Als sie mich dann in ihrer Begeisterung ihrem Chef vorgestellt hatte, ließ der mich verhaften. Zuerst, als seine Assistentin mich vorstellte, war er sehr freundlich. Dann, als ich mich für die Umstände entschuldigt hatte und ihm erzählt habe, wonach ich gesucht habe, er hat eine böse Miene aufgezogen und meinte, ich hätte ihnen so viele Schwierigkeiten verursacht, dass ich keinen Zutritt mehr zu diesem Naturpark hätte. Ich fühle mich verunsichert. Er scheint gewittert zu haben, dass es sich um eine wichtige Entdeckung handelt. Ich wollte das nicht auf die große Glocke hängen, aber Tatsache ist, ich habe nach dieser Raupe 30 Jahre lang gesucht. Das ist ein fehlendes Glied in der Kette. Ich erhoffe mir auch große Erkenntnisse daraus. Ich wollte mit dem Park und mit der Uni zusammenarbeiten. Ich möchte ja diese Menschen in meine Studie mit einbeziehen, aber sie sträuben sich dagegen und wollen mir alles verbieten. Ich gebe nicht auf. Es wird mich nichts zurückhalten. Nur, dass sie es wissen. Ich werde es sonst niemandem erzählen. Aber ich kehre dorthin zurück und werde so lange im Wald bleiben, bis ich die Raupe gefunden habe.
City Berlin in Germany gives shelter to misfits and different-minded people with mysterious past. In Berlin, you can be whoever you want to be. Behind its thin walls, you can hear and listen to many stories. Berlin combines all the good and all the bad of this world. If you are careless and naive, your choices are half chance. Once Berlin has you, it will not easily let you go. If you somehow manage to change your perspective and defeat your dark side, you will find no better place to start new and to call home.
Guten Tag.
Einen
wunderschönen Gruß, guten Tag.
Na, wir sind hier.
Ja, wunderbar. Bitte kommen Sie weiter, aber erschrecken Sie nicht. Aha. Das ist jetzt ein bisschen... Ich bin sonst ein ordentlicher Mensch, aber in den letzten 2 Jahren ist es so, ich habe eine Weile einen Job gehabt in einem Callcenter. Dort war ich tagsüber beschäftigt und bin abends immer erst nach Hause gekommen. Und dann habe ich mir nie die Zeit genommen, aufzuräumen. Und seitdem ist es hier wirklich sehr unordentlich. Also die letzten 2 Jahre habe ich überhaupt nicht aufgeräumt. Und dann habe ich immer wieder nach Dingen gesucht und alles umeinander geschmissen. Demnächst schlüpfen hier ein paar Schmetterlinge. Und eine Art aus Korea oder auch Japan, eine Rodinia fugax. Und ich erwarte die Schmetterlinge. Aber wahrscheinlich schlüpfen sie erst nächstes Jahr. Stolpern Sie bitte nicht, das ist ein bisschen gefährlich. Ich nehme es mir immer wieder vor, aufzuräumen, und zwar richtig schön, aber dafür muss ich dann inspiriert sein und Muße finden. Und das war in den letzten 2 Jahren, wie gesagt, niemals der Fall. Ich bin ein bisschen verwildert in der letzten Zeit. Also wenn man etwas entdeckt und dann voll fasziniert dran arbeitet, möchte man nicht gestört werden. Und meine Erfahrung ist, dadurch, dass man aufräumt, wird ein anderes Hormon frei und dann verliert man aber diesen roten Faden und ist ganz anders drauf und dann schreibt man die Sache nicht zu Ende. Und ich war früher ordentlich und habe sehr viel aufgeräumt und war immer brav und so, wie es sich gehört. Und deswegen habe ich auch an einem Buch vielleicht 30 Jahre lang gearbeitet. Jetzt wird es fertig. Ja, also jetzt habe ich mich darauf konzentriert. Ich habe mich entschlossen zu suchen. Meine Ziele waren zuerst sehr konkret. Ich habe an einem Buch gearbeitet, in dem ich alle wichtigsten Vertreter einer großen Schmetterlingsfamilie vorstellen möchte. Und es hat mich geärgert, dass manche Arten oder ganze Genera nur als Falter bekannt sind, die irgendwelchen Biologen ans Licht geflogen sind und dann in Sammlungen ihr Ende gefunden haben. Wir wissen, dass es diese Arten gibt, aber wir kennen ihre Raupen nicht. Und weil ich in diesem Buch alle solche Stadien, das heißt alle Entwicklungsphasen dieser Arten auch darstellen wollte, habe ich mich entschlossen, nach den Raupen zu suchen. Also ich werde mich in Asien aufhalten, in einer wunderschönen Inselwelt, in der ich die gesuchte Schmetterlingsart vermute. Nicht nur diese, aber vor allem diese. Aber dort gibt es noch viele andere Schmetterlingsarten, die nicht gut oder noch lückenhaft erforscht sind. Und vielleicht finden wir sogar eine neue Art. Aber auf den Philippinen vermute ich diese Raupe in einem bestimmten Biotop. Ich verrate jetzt noch nicht wo, das wird eine Entdeckungsreise sein. Und es ist so, wenn man sucht und forscht, dann sollte diese Forschung auch ein bisschen allgemeiner sein. Ich suche ja auch nach dem Sinn dieser Forschung und meines Lebens allgemein.
Je me suis occupé de beaucoup de langues autour de des études.
Adesso parlo così 30 lingue, o 28, 32, non so esattamente.
And the message for today, okay? Lucky Omen now could feel the essence of his grace. He will be in front of you with something to offer according to his dictate. Followers shall present themselves with mission to accomplish, and you will be recognized. Here and there, your words will be a wisdom which will be honored by those who have faith in God.
Thank you.
It was the 8th of February 2014 on a cold morning with temperatures below zero when I attended the reenactment of baptism by the river Savisia of the great Slovenian poet Dr. France Pešeren. Bostjan did his annual event, reading verses from the book and singing the national anthem of Slovenia. Not far away was the International Film Festival Berlinale. Bostjan intended to swim in the lake, but the officials were not fond of his performance, and even if he had all the permits, he was cut short and was not allowed to swim. But later that week, he secretly returned and quickly jumped in the artificial lake to conclude his performance. Due to global warming, we went from -6 to +6 in just 2 days.
Is Wasser kalt?
Es geht nass vor allem, nass. Nicht so kalt wie normal, aber doch auch eisig. Kalt werden die Füße und die Hände. Da muss man ein bisschen aufpassen, aber man kann sich dann so schön warm halten, indem man ein bisschen so auf der Stelle herumtritt oder notfalls etwas läuft. Aber allgemein ist es so, bei Menschen mit diesem Typ von Kreislauf werden die Gliedmaßen zuerst kalt, über die wird normalerweise die meiste Wärme abgestrahlt. Aber das ist sehr gut, weil durch diese Isolierung dann das Blut in die inneren Organe fließt. Das bedeutet, hier ist dann der mittlere Teil des Körpers sicher und man kollabiert nicht, auch nach mehreren Stunden notfalls.
Es ist natürlich lebensbedrohlich, sich zu lange in einem eiskalten Wasser aufzuhalten, aber auch das kann man teilweise überleben. Es gibt Menschen mit einer besonderen Fettschicht und die wären in der Lage, mehrere Stunden lang in eiskaltem Wasser zu schwimmen. Oder wenn man sich richtig bewegt, kann man den Körper durch Tricks vielleicht so weit bringen, dass man es doch überlebt. Also es ist viel mehr möglich, als wir denken.
I decided to take this chance to change my life a little bit. So a private apartment is very fine, of course. You have your freedom, you are alone, you can invite people, make a party, which I didn't do very often. So I didn't take those possibilities. But on the other hand, it will be much cheaper now. I decided to live with another person, with a very, very good friend with me, with a woman who invited me to settle down with her in the same apartment. The only problem I have is the big amount of books and notices and manuscripts and all the things I have, the texts, which I don't even possess on my own. So many of them are my father's or my grandfather's texts or even others. So when my father lived in Prague in 1968, doing his PhD just before Prague was occupied by the Wars of Pact, he got a big amount, a truck of books, to save them to Yugoslavia because the books were at risk to be lost in this movement. And this is a big responsibility. So I took over the books from my father when he moved, when he had to leave the bigger apartment in Ulm where we lived. And this is a big responsibility. But, you know, in Slovenian, the word for ownership, for possessment, is last. Moja last is something of my own. It's the ownership. And in German, this very word means burden. A burden, something that limits you, that causes you difficulties. I will take some cocoons with me. Some of them may even develop.
What do you mean develop? They are still...
They are still full, yes. So they didn't... They are not dead. But some of them are also... are already empty. So the moths did leave them. Like here, for example. This is an Indian species living in southern India on big trees. It's all made of silk and they are very hard. They like a stone.
Mm-hmm.
And also this peduncle is made of hard silk and they hang from the trees like old fruits and are not eaten by birds. This is a very fine thing, but it's problematic. Those are the seeds of the famous ginkgo tree. In Berlin, you can find some alleys, some roads planted with ginkgo trees. And I used together.
To see.
Yeah, they are very stinky. They awfully stink, but from those seeds, the trees were germinate and grow, the ginkgo trees.
It's a little bit too dark. Can you open it a little bit more?
Yeah. And they attract flies in high amounts. And I have many of them, so many hundreds of kilograms. But what the most people don't know, they can be eaten and they are delicious. So when this is removed, this outer skin, which is so stinky, and you wash them out, and then you open the kernels and bake them, they can be eaten. And here, for example, it's quite curious. I found a big amount of seeds of the pine trees from Porto Roche, where I'm born. My mother and my sister have gathered them for me. I had a strange habit to give some people seeds from pine trees as a present. So they may try to plant them in a pot or in their gardens. And this would make them lucky, and then they can cultivate such a pine tree or a palm or something else. Schmetterlinge haben mich schon als Kind fasziniert. Als ich 5 war, habe ich ein schönes Buch erhalten als Geschenk und darin habe ich ein Raupenfoto bewundert. Eine wunderschöne Raupe. Und der Zufall wollte, dass ich einmal bei einem Spaziergang mit meinen Eltern am Strand diese Raupe gefunden habe. So eine riesengroße gelbe Raupe mit blauen Seitenstreifen. Wir haben sie mit nach Hause genommen und zu Hause mit Salat gefüttert. Aber die Raupe wollte das nicht fressen. Sie hat sich zu Hause verpuppt, ist dann nächstes Jahr, also nach der Überwinterung, als Schmetterling geschlüpft. Und diesen Schmetterling haben wir von der Terrasse fliegen lassen in Piran, in meiner Heimatstadt. Und das war für mich ein Erlebnis wie eine kleine Mondlandung. Und seitdem habe ich dann jede Raupe immer aufgehoben, die ich fand. Habe sie zu Hause gefüttert. Habe dann erfahren, dass jede Raupe ihre eigene Futterpflanze braucht. Und so hat sich dann die Leidenschaft entwickelt, nach und nach. Und das geht bis heute. Ich kann es nicht lassen. When we consider the two stages, the pupa or the cocoon and the caterpillar on the one side and the moth or the butterfly on the other, we can realize that they are not really the same animal. So they are built of other cells. There is, of course, some continuity within the species. So from the same caterpillar, always the same species of moth will develop, and there is no other possibility. On the other hand, this resurrection of the moth from a pupa, from a mummy in the earth, led to our religious connotations. And therefore the idea arose to make mummies, even of human beings, of a pharaoh, for example, and to burrow them into earth or into a pyramid.
and let them survive in the same way, hoping that after some time they will resurrect.
So, Bostjan, when do you plan the trip to document your caterpillar?
I don't have the real evidence that the species of caterpillars I found are of quite that species, but I find this very probable. I have a feeling that this is quite this caterpillar. Maybe the caterpillar itself is not really relevant for science, which is not true at all. So it may be a shame that in a very well-known species, which is frequent and can be found everywhere in, or almost everywhere in tropical Asia, the caterpillar is not yet known, was not documented. But this is probably not so relevant, but it's just important for me, so as I have the wish to finish a book about this family of moths and to document them in all the stages of their life history, so to have some picture of the egg, the caterpillar, the pupa, and the moth itself.
Hallo Vasja, schön, dass du da bist. Ich glaube, wir schaffen es mit den Tickets. Es wurde am Wochenende viel gesoffen. Also es ist so, dass wir noch ein bisschen brauchen, aber ich habe jetzt schon, das ist die 20. Runde. Für 300 Euro habe ich jetzt gesammelt. Ich wollte ja schon immer an der Uni zum Lehrgutverwerter annoncieren und es ist ganz praktisch. Wenn du mir noch ein bisschen mithilfst, haben wir es bis zum Morgengrauen geschafft, glaube ich. Dann können wir bei dir und bei mir Flaschen lagern und können wir uns die Tickets leisten. Wir brauchen vielleicht noch 150 bis 200 Euro, aber das haben wir bald. Ja, das ist die sicherste Einnahmequelle hier, wenn alles andere versagt. Früher bin ich in die Pilze gegangen, jetzt gehe ich in die Flaschen. Man entwickelt einen Blick dafür, ich sehe sie schon an jeder Ecke.
Before going to the Philippines, the producer contacted the Philippine Embassy in Berlin for possible support. He got the following answer.
May I also bring to your attention the information received by the Denier from the McKilling Forest Reserve Management, mentioning that Dr. Bostjan Dvorak appears to have committed a violation of Philippine laws, which undoubtedly would lead to complications if you decide to continue with the production of the documentary.
Uh-oh, this is bad. After this information, the producer and Bostjan decided to conduct the research on the neighboring mountain to avoid any complications until the matter is resolved. But before we get there, Dr. Bostjan visited a special friend in Manila, whom he promised to return to, a prophet who will give him guidance.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Amen. O God, the Father Almighty, bless this food that we're about to receive. And yes, Lord, touch our hearts so that we will do our task according to your will. And Lord, guide us and lead us to whatever is there that we have to accomplish as these people come over here with mission. And then let us blend together for this to have a success and victory for the sake of humanity. Make us the instrument of peace and we will do our role and do something for this to be in reality. And in Jesus' name, in God's name, and whatever name you want us to call you, then let it be. And we say, Amen.
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 Right in. Hello there.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah. Hello there.
Hello.
Okay, get your plane. Okay.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Welcome.
I would like to introduce a friend of mine from Manila. This is Miss Julie, Dr. Mahal from Manila. And I got to know her when I was here for the first time. I was introduced to her. And I'm very happy to see you again.
Oh my, that's a good thing. Okay, welcome, Bostjan. Okay, you are a such a wonderful character that I have met 2 years ago. Now you're back.
I'm looking for this caterpillar again, which I already found, but I was not able to document it. Oh. So I hope to find it again and to take a picture of its pupa. Do you think I will be successful?
Of course you can, you know. There is a power there, you know. So look at that. This is a place of sacredness, and your mind is good, your heart is pure. You
I'm know, happy
everything
to hear
will
that.
Be in order. Okay,
I so. Feel that you know the purposes of a people's life, and also mine.
Mount Banahaw is a dormant volcano, 2,170 meters high. It is a huge and vast mountain with dense rainforest. For the villagers, it is a holy place, a sacred ground. Nearby is a secret and sacred cave where no foreign film crew has ever been or was allowed to film. The river that comes down from the mountain near the village is crystal clear, and it is said to have healing powers. They say Jesus walked this land and left a footprint on a rock under the riverbed. There is a big mystery surrounding the village and the mountain. In the evening, we finally met the villagers and our guide, Jason. We explained to them what we came here to do.
Jason, I'm so happy to meet you finally. It was not easy to find you, but finally it worked. Would you guide me to the mountain tomorrow?
Yes. But before we go to the mountain, we pray.
Yes.
To find the caterpillar.
Yes, I hope so.
Yes.
We will.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Because of the sacred grounds and the secrets the mountain holds, many of them were uneased with our intentions. They suggested that we go to the sacred cave and pray for safe passage to the mountain. We agreed only after we ate the traditional food called balut. Coconut wine really helped.
Filipino name, balut.
Balut.
It's best when you combine with this, salt or vinegar.
So these are dead birds.
It's a yolk of an egg, the yellow.
So the
it's like an egg, yes.
Yes, yes.
It's like an egg.
It's an egg,
but almost already being transformed as a
into chicks, but
okay,
maybe 21 days.
Thank you very much. This was.
Still under the influence of last night, we woke up early as not to disturb any pilgrims and went to the sacred cave to pray. The holy river guards the approach to the cave, and some unexplained forces prevented us from filming in the cave. The camera refused to record. There was some electromagnetic interference in and around the cave. After many tries, we managed to record a scene, but only in the first-person view, the passage through the cave. The cave is around 50 to 70 meters long and has an elevation of some 8 meters. It is mostly very narrow. There were some parts in the cave only 70 centimeters high and in some places 30 to 50 centimeters wide. Inside were many statues and places to pray. Because we were the first visitors today, there were no candles to point and light the way. We were in complete darkness. The water running through the cave is used for baptism. This blocks the passage through the cave for several minutes, and people caught in the cave at that time experience lack of oxygen, panic, and claustrophobia. I have to tell you, we felt a little relieved coming out of the cave, like we had left a burden behind, and we could finally start looking for the caterpillar. Climbing the mountain is not an easy task. The air is humid, the path very muddy and slippery. There are no signs or directions, so going without a guide would be dangerous. It is a huge mountain with hidden crevices and steep slopes. We passed many small farms where you can grow almost anything due to the volcanic soil. Every break we made, we could enjoy fruits growing everywhere around us. It was like the description of heaven. Fresh coconut, cacao, mango, papaya, and many wild berries. The forest is rich and dense. It is a place for a biologist to be, and the perfect scenery for an Indiana Jones movie. We encountered many strange-looking insects, but we didn't have time to study them. We had to move on, because the night in this part of the world comes swiftly and immediately after sunset.
Thank you so much for bringing me here. In this nice forest, I try to find a special caterpillar. So, uot gamo gamo. It is not a butterfly, it is a moth. And I suppose this caterpillar lives on two species of trees that may be found here. And the moths are frequently found. They are caught by light because they are attracted by light. And for some 500 years, they were collected in this area, but nobody cares and knows about the caterpillar. Mm-hmm. But I cannot finish my book when I don't know the caterpillar. And last time when I was here, I found some of them, and I suppose they are of this species. Now I would like to see some more caterpillars of this species and their pupa.
We were exhausted, so we decided for a longer rest before pushing on to the base camp. But not Dr. Bostjan. He had another idea.
Now I'm very excited. I already saw some traces of caterpillars on plants. And now we are getting higher to a place which is humid. The base is not far away. And from there, I will conduct my research.
While resting, we briefly looked away, and Bostjan just took off on his own. He was gone for nearly 3 hours. Our guy, Jason, and the producer were very, very nervous.
Bostjan! Bostjan!
Hello.
Oh, hello, Bostjan.
Oh,
I'm so worried about you.
Really?
Yes.
Jason, many it's traps, so wonderful.
Many traps are wild pig there.
Ah, yes. So
I'm so worried.
I saw so beautiful trees and two big snakes and a pig, but the snakes just followed away, and I saw only a few caterpillars.
some from the other families, not the one I look for. Yes, but it's such a wonderful forest.
But a dangerous mountain, because a trap of the wild pig.
Wild pigs?
Wild pig trap.
Yes, so I didn't eat them. But the temptation was big, so they seem delicious. Are they poisonous? Okay, so they should be cooked, probably.
Yeah. Okay, now look, there's obviously some sort of misunderstanding here. Look, let's take a break and start again.
I like wild pigs, but I'm really afraid of traps.
Yes.
Jason, what kind of traps are there in the forest?
So many, like a bomb.
Like a bomb?
Yes.
So they could explode?
Yes. Your legs is a bomb there.
Oh my God, I didn't know about that. So I will never leave you again.
No.
You are right to worry about me.
I'm so worried.
Yes, I'm sorry.
Next time...
It will not happen again.
Yes.
I stay without, always with you.
Damn, man. It's dangerous to walk around on unfamiliar terrain in a foreign country where they catch animals with landmines. He has to tame his spirit because he needs to come back in one piece. He has to finish his book and he has to find his bug. The mountain holds many secrets. Higher on the mountain are different armed groups guarding their crops and its secrets. One of the oldest and still active communistic rebel armed groups is called New People's Army, and it's known to be active in this region. They are well organized and use guerrilla tactics trying to overthrow the government. We need to be careful.
On the second day of our expedition, we will continue to some higher elevation and reach the Forbidden Forest. The summits of those beautiful mountains are generally forbidden for several reasons, but it's quite there that I expect the caterpillar to live, so we have to continue. We just received a message from our guide's sister. She's saying us that we should not go the direction we wanted because of some, religious and other restrictions. I think this is a sign. Maybe this is a sign from God that the caterpillar is on another place. So we will change our plan and follow our guide in the other direction. I really hope to find this caterpillar.
That's just weird, man. After a plea from the villagers, Jason took a path he was unfamiliar with. He was not sure which path to take because there was no path to take.
What is this?
New People Army, rebels against the government.
Is it like Robin Hood or something else? Yeah, so I think it's our common forest, so we'll protect it. It's our...
But
good. We are friends.
It's good for me.
We are all friends, I think. Yes. Okay. But what's wrong? Why should we stop? Yes, maybe the caterpillar is here.
Yes.
So we should continue.
Okay.
There is another misunderstanding. Let's take a break and start again.
What's that? Are you familiar with NPA?
What is this?
Armed rebels fighting to overthrow the government. This is their abandoned military post.
New People Army, rebels against the government.
Is it like Robin Hood or something else? Yeah, so I think it's our common forest, so we'll protect it. It's our...
But it's good.
We are friends.
It's good for me.
We are all friends, I think.
Yes.
Okay.
But what's wrong? Why should we stop?
We need to be careful here. They're all around us. It's dangerous here.
And, yes, maybe the caterpillar is here.
Yes.
So we should continue.
We should go around.
Okay.
Thank you.
New People's Army tend to take hostages from time to time, but they usually leave foreign civilians alone. There is the danger of possible mistaken identity, ambushes, and minefields. So we need to move fast away from this path. It was a steep and demanding hike through dense vegetation full of obstacles and spiky plants. Bostjan fell twice and luckily held himself onto some branches as not to fall over the cliff. We walked, crawled, and climbed for many hours, not getting anywhere. We were definitely lost. We were too high and the trail was getting too steep and narrow. We would need climbing gear to proceed.
For somebody who is not a climber, this would take maybe a day. I'm not sure. Maybe this is a risk, because nobody has ever been here, maybe. So you really did your best, but we realize local people do not go here. So therefore, we shouldn't risk. I'm healed now. I'm really afraid, so somebody of us will fall down.
We wasted one whole precious day, and now it's too late to conduct any research, because we had to come down to the camp before the night. Bostjan is not any closer of finding his elusive caterpillar as he was a day or 30 years ago. He needs to rethink his strategy.
This night, I hope to attract some moth species on light. So in the evening, we built a light trap. And really, some of the moths flew on the light. They were attracted, but they didn't rest. They just left after some seconds. One of those moths, I'm very excited about this, seemed to be just the species I'm looking for. I'm looking for its caterpillar. Ici, nous avons trouvé une place idéale où la chrysalide de ce papillon nocturne de sphinx se pourrait trouver. Bien que cette espèce d'arbre, qui est un figuier, ne soit pas probablement la nourriture de cette chenille, on y peut trouver sa chrysalide. Et c'est ça le problème. Alors, la chrysalide peut se trouver théoriquement partout, parce que les chenilles sont très mobiles. C'est ça le problème, on peut la chercher, mais il n'y a pas la garantie de la trouver. This beautiful plant is a real surprise, because I realize that its underside is somewhat similar to the backside of the caterpillar I'm looking for. So it may fit. It may be such a community between plant and caterpillar, and maybe its original host plant. I am not sure.
And these are some traces of the famous civet. It's the producer of the most expensive coffee. So everywhere in those woods, you can find beautiful coffee bushes in full blossom and also with many fruits. And those cats, which are not really cats, it's a similar animal of another group of mammals, gather the berries and eat them. And these specially fermented and transformed berries then come out and people gather them and brew them to a special delicious coffee. Jason, what's this?
This is bula.
Bula?
Bula. And insect inside. Like this.
Ah. They develop inside?
Yes.
Ah. This is a pupa?
No, not pupa. Insects. Only insects.
Uh-huh.
So many, many.
Ah.
The next day, Dr. Bostjan had an idea, a risky one.
Ngayon na kahanap uod gamu gamu ko. Gamu gamu non paru paro. So I am looking for big caterpillars of night flying moths. So moth gamu gamu, not of butterflies. So they are related. And I look on some plants. Maybe you have seen such a big worm-like creature with a horn on its end, very big, green or yellow and blue stripes. Did you? Can you translate?
Minakikita kung minakikita daw kayo na ano, yung mga uod na malalaki, caterpillar.
Sa mga punong kahoy sa ano, tsaka yung may guhit.
Green, yellow.
Mm.
Oh, yung
mga ganyan. Siya mga mura. Yung mga murang
He said it's a lukban tree and daranghita.
On lukban tree. And they are under the leaves.
Yes.
And the horn is a little bit like so, like S.
Yes.
This kind. Okay. Yes. And they are on lukban tree.
Lukban tree and calamansi tree.
Also calamansi.
Banu tree.
They are related.
Yes. Yes.
This is very interesting. That's it.
We found a possible lead on the caterpillar that Dr. Bostjan is looking for. But his only problem is that the trees the two local farmers mentioned are mostly found on the path we were not allowed to go. The caterpillar is also found higher on the mountain as Dr. Bostjan thought it would be. He found some of the trees and traces of the caterpillars, but none at this elevation. It's getting more and more complicated.
I try to find a pupa from the species I'm looking for. So this is very soft soil between the roots of a tree. It's a fig tree, but in such an environment I suppose the pupa to lay and to wait for the butterfly, so until the moth emerges from it. And it should lay like maybe some centimeters under earth or among leaves on such very, very humid places with lots of moisture, because the pupae are endangered by dry weather.
Now Bostjan got it. We were on the wrong side of the mountain. It was the sunny side that's too dry. The only thing that we can do now is to take the path that we're not allowed to take due to the religious restrictions. Should we risk it and take the path that's too dangerous and restricted?
Jason's friend has just found a skin of a pupa. This is a dried out pupa. It's thin skin when the moth already left. And it's probably the Smirintine subfamily of the family of the caterpillar we are looking for. Nevertheless, we find some traces, but at the time the weather is very dry. So the caterpillars have pupated, or they just escaped somewhere, and we don't find any of them. On the leaves here, on the riverside, we find many traces. Traces of eaten leaves. So the underside of the leaves were populated by big caterpillars, which already pupated.
no caterpillars. There is something Bostjan missed. Are we really on the wrong side of the mountain? There are places with enough humidity, juicy and eaten leaves, but no caterpillars. If the caterpillars are already pupated, where are they?
At this nice place, I am trying to attract some wonderful tropical Asian swallowtails and beautiful dragonflies, as they like minerals mixed with water. For that purpose, I didn't wash for many days. I'm curious about which species will land on me. So, let's see. Last time at this place, I found several different folk moth species as caterpillars everywhere. This time, I only find some traces of them, but no caterpillar at all. Why is that? I am really curious about that. I hope they did not die out in the meantime, but I hope it's not the case. I will continue to look after my caterpillar, and I am sure to find it. I'll not give up.
Welcome to Bostjan's dream.
Ichisa so Sanje. Turi Sanje so.
So here comes a friend who served as the scientist from University of Berlin. And this is the year of what we call fulfillment of the subject.
The prophet continued and predicted that Bostjan in 2017 will meet a Filipino actress that has a tattoo of a butterfly on a very special place on her body that he needs to examine, and could hold a clue of the whereabouts of his caterpillar. I like this prediction.
Občudujem tvoje zelo, zelo široko zanimanje, ne samo za jezikoslovje, pa za filozofijo in tako dalje, ampak tudi za naravoslovje.
Ti si ga so povzročil, takrat, ko si me kot otroka uvajal v te stvari. In jaz tih osence ne bi začel iskati, če ne bi šli takrat v Nemčijo.
Ja.
The chronicle of the caterpillar.
But it was long. Why should we stop?
After our first part of the expedition and investigation after the caterpillar, I am really surprised about the big richness of plants growing here, but a little bit disappointed about the fact that we did not find the caterpillar yet. And there are fewer caterpillars than a year or two before. Maybe it's a very dry season, but so we will look after it in another environment again. So we will continue our search for the caterpillar and also other caterpillars in other parts of this wonderful forest.
Villagers heard about our misfortune on the mountain, so they participated and gathered some caterpillars from their gardens. Caterpillars are for them worms and pests, but now that they know what they are becoming more interested in them and want to know their purpose. There are caterpillars and butterflies all over the village. They are so-called cultural followers. After all that running around, the caterpillars, pupas and butterflies, and moths were in front of our noses all the time. Nevertheless, we gathered lots of important information that can help with the discovery and the book.
Garden.
Look,
Dr. Bostjan knows that if he wants to document his caterpillar, he has to take a risk and take the path to the top of the mountain, or return to where he first encountered it. But it will not be so easy, because it means returning to the place where he was banned from. So, we have come to the end of our story. So what if we haven't found the caterpillar yet? We'll find it some other day. It's not the finding that's important. It's the search of it all. And you know what? Maybe that's the Holy Grail.